Good evening, good morning, good afternoon, wherever you're watching. We are in the early evening hours here in Minsk, Belarus. It's the FIBA Under-17 Women's Basketball World Cup Final between France and the United States. A battle of unbeatens. And the USA, well, they made the podium a couple years ago in Zaragoza, but it was in third place. They are now one win away from getting to the top. And France going for their first title in this competition in this fifth edition of the event. Australia have already come from behind to beat Hungary to win third place. Australia were the winners 2 years ago in Zaragoza, Spain. But right now, it's all about France and this team, the USA. And judging from their team's performances yesterday, we should be in for a good one. And Jeff Taylor joined by Shona Thorberg, the Canada international and Olympian. And Shona, you know what? It's not too difficult to get up for a game like this.
No, absolutely not. And, you know, I don't think France is happy just to be in this game. Let's put it that way. I really think after the performance that we saw in the second half by France, they have to have confidence going into this game. They really do. And, I know they're going up against a more athletic, a taller team, but you know, no one's happy to be here. They both want to be top of the podium.
And let's don't forget, I mean, there is some serious, serious talent in this French team.
There really is. I mean, you know, I think right away the person that you think about is Rupert. Hasn't played a whole lot in the tournament leading up to yesterday's game because she was kind of battling a little bit of an ankle injury. But talk about a performance yesterday. She had 20 points, 14 rebounds, 6 blocks, 4 steals. MVP performance, absolutely.
That player there, Jordan Forston, was fantastic.
Absolutely.
The USA and their win over Hungary.
I mean, I think there's a few candidates on this USA team, but Forston was just unbelievable. She had 18 points on 12 shots. 6 rebounds, 4 assists, 4 steals. She really did absolutely everything for that USA team early in the game against Hungary. And right now, we're watching MVP candidates go up against each other.
Yeah, and you know, what's impressive really about both of those players, but especially Horston, was that, you know, it wasn't about her getting all of her points. I mean, she was making plays. It just so happened that she was scoring a lot of points. She had 14 points in the first half yesterday, and really we saw the USA press just really take over that game early, although a lot of that had to do with Hungary just not functioning at all. They were their own worst enemies. But on the other hand, France were in real trouble against Australia. They were down 15 points at halftime. They came out, and boy, they had a different look in their eyes. And they came out and pressed and pressed and pressed and just took over the game with that full-court press. Kendra Sherry, remember, there she is. She was awesome yesterday. And as was Rupert, as, you know, Fatou, the captain, came out, was terrific in the second half. It was a great second half comeback by France.
It really was. And, you know, maybe Kendra Sherry, the things that she does don't really show up on the stat sheet. She's not the prettiest of scorers, basketball players, but, man, and was she important for the comeback by France yesterday?
We're going to have a pause here in commentary for the playing of the national anthems. Vasiliki Sarucha from Greece and Mikhail Port from Poland. There you have it. Wow. Three referees going to the final. I guess they've been the best three in the tournament. That's how they've been judged. And we're going to get a look at the rosters for both the USA as well as France. And a lot of people here watching this future talent, and they want any of these players to come play for them. Probably in college.
Absolutely, you know, AZ Fudd, named after the famous Jennifer AZ. Keep an eye out, she's MVP candidate. Beckers, I thought, got off to a slow start yesterday. I could see her coming out being a little bit more aggressive. You know, Jordan Horston, like I said, MVP from yesterday. And then the post players, Haley Jones and Aliyah Boston. I mean, points in the paint yesterday was big for the U.S., so keep an eye on those two players as well.
If Jennifer Azy knows that possibly the best player, one of the best players in this USA team has been named after her. I'm guessing she must.
And one of the youngest players in this tournament.
What about this French team?
You know, you look at Marie Fotu, rough start yesterday, rough game to be honest. She hit a big three later. Wadu leading basically this tournament in three-point shot attempts, four out of 11 yesterday. So if she can get going, but I think what it's going to come down to, you know, Iwodu had a great game for them yesterday, led them in assists. Kendra Sherry, she was a difference maker, but not statistically. So keep an eye on her. And then the MVP of this team is Rupert. And you know, she obviously has basketball in her blood, her father being an ex-national team player.
As does Fo too.
As does Fo too, exactly. So, you know, this is a very, very talented French team.
Karlan Berube.
You know, ex-UConn player,
yep.
So, hey, she also has a lot of basketball knowledge. She's been with the program a few years now coaching these younger teams, and, you know, she's clearly been taught by the best, having played at UConn under Gino Auriemma. Arno, I mean, he coaches 8 of these players in INSEP, so he's been around, he knows them, he also knows how to motivate them, and I think that's what we saw yesterday. They were down 15, they went into the half, and he clearly knew how to talk to the women because they came out a completely different team, and that's just from knowing them, spending time with them, and there you go. I mean, that's why they're here today.
Some of the parents made the journey to Minsk to watch their daughters play, all the way from the U.S. of A. And as well as France, they have come.
It's not quite as far.
Not quite as far, but, you know, still a commitment, I have to say. Remember, France, USA played some big games at senior team level over the years, including the final. Was it of the 2012 Olympics?
It was. You know, you saw that great performance by Céline Dumerc during that Olympic run for France. And, you know, keep an eye on Marine Fouteau tonight because a lot of people in France are excited about her. And, you know, it's her court awareness.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Minsk, Belarus. This is the final of the FIBA Under 17 Women's Basketball World Cup. Between France in the white, and the USA red, white, and blue. And it's France that have won that opening tip. With these teams coming off contrasting victories yesterday. Erodu starts things off with a long jump shot.
And this is what I love. They make a basket, and look, they are in that full court press, which is what got them back into the game. And I'm really glad that they're doing this early because they need to slow this U.S. team down.
A beautiful bounce pass to Beckers from Jones. Yesterday it was Jones that started things off with her scoring, and now she delivers that beautiful backdoor pass. Pass to the backdoor cutter. Wadu for three, and that was long, and then it went off the foot of Erodu.
You know, no surprise there. We saw Wadu come out firing yesterday. She's come out firing in her previous games, averages 8.4 threes a game, attempts a game, sorry. So, you know, that's part of her game. Maybe not what you would always shoot, but that's who she is, and, you know, you let her ride it.
She's got the green light.
She definitely does.
Head over to Jones now. Now she's going to put up a three. And the ball rattles out. Ballston is wrapping away inside. And she's fouled.
And you know, what I think is really important for this French team is to come out and not be intimidated. It's easy to play against the U.S. and be intimidated. They are intimidating. Their size, their physicality. And I think that's what France needs to not worry about.
Well, Borsten gets her first 2 points of the game. Get used to that. She pours in the points on this USA team.
She really does, and that was just a good job running the play, and I thought it was a great pass to the open cutter as well. Kind of hit her before she was going to be open.
That foul at the other end was on Erodu. Now another turnover. And called against France. Pressure here to make things awkward, and already the USA turned it over, and Fotu goes in but gets swatted out of bounds by Jones.
You know, good job by Jones, kind of make up for that turnover.
Now the excellent defense by Horston with the steal, pulls up, misses the shot. So both teams missing shots, not cashing in on opportunities, although USA get it back. Boston, the the work. Duperre gets the rebound. Over to Iwodu. And then her pass right into the hands of Horson. What is it? It's like a magnet for passes straight into her hands.
We saw her have three consecutive steals yesterday in the span of maybe 24 seconds.
Now Beckridge goes up, has it knocked out of her hands by Duperre, but then she gets it back. Now Jones goes up. Oh, she gets it to fall. And one is coming for Jones. And foul by Duperre.
And, you know, I think that's a great call by the ref because Duperre, unfortunately, again, you see so many players. They have good position. She did do a pretty good job on defense. If she had just kept her arms straight up instead of lowering them, it wouldn't have been a foul. And I can guarantee you Jones probably would not have made that basket.
So Haley Jones did not make the free throw. USA with a 6-2 lead. The battle of the heavyweights here. Duperre rejected by Horston. Now Jones. I don't think Duperre can quite believe it. Horston for three. That was not a strong suit yesterday for the USA in their semifinal win over Hungary.
And you know, so far we've kind of seen Duperre get a bad foul, and then she was taken out of her shot just most recently on the baseline. It's interesting to see because...
Well, that was a tough shot by Duperre.
That's not what she wanted to do.
And Beckers crosses midcourt. Yeah, Duperre doesn't...
You'll see her level against these U.S. bigs. Let's put it that way. You know, I said she had an MVP-type performance yesterday, but she's going up against taller and stronger bigs today.
Foot. And... Oh, boy, that is not good for France. The Boston beat them to the long rebound into the corner. Beckers over to Fudd. Good! France called timeout to try to stop this USA run.
You know, I don't think Fudd's going to miss two shots in a row, so...
We talked about her efficiency coming into this.
Yeah, you know,
she's good.
Anyone on this U.S. team is capable of scoring, capable of being a leader on the team, and up until yesterday, really, she was that player for them, and if she has a great game tonight, I mean, she could even be MVP of this tournament, so she's not someone you can leave open. You know what, France right now, they came back against Australia, down 15 at half, because what, you do not want to get down 15 early to the U.S. That is a different team that it's not... cannot afford to do that.
And what has to be worrying for France is the shot attempt by Duperre. Down the court.
You know,
she was falling away from the basket.
She was.
About 15 feet.
There was 4 seconds left.
Take that shot.
No, absolutely not. You don't take that shot. There was 4 seconds left, I think. You know, it's nerve-wracking for her. She is now going up against probably the toughest competition she has ever played against. Let's be honest. You know, until next year when she plays in Bourges, she's going to be playing in EuroLeague. She's going to have to get used to that. But she needs to get her composure right now and realize, you know what, if I get the ball in a position, I have the skill set, I need to have confidence. We haven't seen that yet. I mean, it's still early though.
Who has it? Oh, and another interception right into the hands of Horston. And Horston drives in and scores and also takes the bump. And the French, I don't know what it is. I mean, it's like it's almost as if they don't see Horston. She's right there. She's lurking. And the lead is now 10-2. What's he saying? Bounce pass? Don't pass it?
Yeah.
A smart pass?
That ball screen. I think she kind of wanted to pass to Duperre, but they got a little nervous because the big from the U.S. kind of hedged out a little bit. She was worried about throwing it up and over and tried to hit the riser, and clearly that's not there. This U.S. team is too good to play like that.
Look at, now, Becker's almost coming up with a steal. So, Horston actually takes a seat here and is replaced by Zaya Cook. I thought it was pretty tough yesterday. Chevy brings the ball up the court, goes right at Jones. still a relatively tough shot. And now Fudge for the USA. Zach Cook. And Boston with the rebound. Turns, scores. You know, the USA Bigs didn't have to be the dominant force yesterday, but they come out tonight.
They definitely do. I would say the talent on this USA team is their guard position, but I think maybe the bigs just haven't really been challenged, and they've let the guards kind of take over in this tournament. So now that they notice that there is a little bit more challenge, maybe we're going to see them step out. And, you know, we just saw that miss down on the other end, that three by Cook. And if there is one part of the game that the U.S. is lacking in, I mean, I'm being nitpicky right now, eh? I'm trying to find something. But I think it would be their three-point shooting. You know, they're only shooting just under 32%. Not great for a U.S. team, but they also don't take a lot, though. So they are conscious of that, which is great.
Reverse move. Oh, France still can't get it to go. You know, it's a tough start. Owodu, good play. They just didn't finish.
Yeah, great look by Owodu. And the problem is, you know, opportunities like that don't come along often from a USA team. So you got to make them, unfortunately.
So it drives in, and once again, the USA with a potential three-point play. And if she does convert this opportunity, USA are going to be on top by 14 points. Nightmare start for France.
Yeah, it really is. You know, they need a, you know, I don't think Coach should call another timeout, but they need to get a score and a stop right now to just kind of calm things down.
This USA team probably a little bit harder to come back against than Australia. But that said, they did come back against Australia, just like with in the blink of an eye. Here's Wadu for three. Finally, something positive for the French.
And that's what they need, but right now they also need a stop. That's the most important thing right now.
Pardon in the game as well. Number five. Miss by USA, an easy one for France, believe me, but over now to the French. Cup is there, Wadu puts it up and good. And then Wadu takes an inverted shot to the face from Jones. She looks a little dazed as she goes up the court.
It wasn't intentional at all, but it was pretty hard.
Well, how about that? A little bit of shake. I think she did a little bit of baking. She was cooking. Beautiful pass again. Went to repair. And what I don't like about that, honestly, she's falling away from the basket. She's got to go strong to the basket.
I saw exactly what you did. She kind of had pretty good positioning, but I think she's really intimidated about getting blocked.
And the basket for the USA by Jones.
I mean, Jones starts at four for this US team. She guards the four, but really she plays like a three. I think moving, you know, as she gets older, as she progresses, I can see her playing the three later on.
Bounced out. Repair was right under the basket. And boy, the USA are just turning it on big time right now against the French. Beckers. Zaya Cook dribbling behind the back. Beckers gets inside. And Belibi fouled will go to the line.
You know, what's disappointing is that Rupert, you know, let's take a look at this. She just gets outworked. I mean, it was a great job by the U.S. player to sort of put push her for better rebounding position. And those are the things where, you know, I don't know if Rupaire is at that next level yet. She's 17. She's going to get there. She's going to learn a lot next year in Orange from the coaching staff there and just playing against, you know, the professional woman there. But, you know, you just saw how much stronger and maybe a little bit further ahead this U.S. team is right now from this French team.
Well, the missed free throw, and USA almost got it back. They're up by 14. Wadu thought about it. Gets it to Owodu. Oh, and then she turns it over.
Rupaire's got to be careful here because she has two, and you would hate to see her get her third.
And turn down low, and then Rupaire fouled by Celeste Taylor.
I'm actually surprised that France is keeping Rupaire in the game right now with two fouls. You know what I mean? It's a long game. I know you're down, and I know you need her, but 31 minutes left in the game, and she has two fouls, and she's still playing.
Levy, but then Owodu takes it back, and then she's fouled by Celeste Taylor.
That's Celeste's second foul also pretty quickly. I mean, good job by Owodu for kind of getting her hand in there. And we noticed this yesterday, in the earlier game, the bronze medal game, the refs are really letting them play. You know, it's an aggressive game. They're not calling cheap, easy touch fouls. You know, you're getting... You're allowed to play physical now.
Go two for three. Drains it. Boy, every basket that France makes right now is, you just feel it is vital for them to stay in this thing.
It really is.
Under the early storm. Beckers for three.
You know, I love that when France can score, they can get into kind of their press. And obviously...
Much better from France, but Rupaire simply can't get it going. I almost feel like USA are doing France a favor when they shoot those three pointers.
Right? Yeah.
Because they're not attacking the basket. They're not really, you know... I just wonder with Beckers if that's the shot she needs to be taking.
Yeah.
Rupaire comes out. She's going to try to calm down. Chevy comes back in.
You know, you'd love to see Couture have a big game because she struggled a little bit yesterday. You know, it wasn't until the fourth quarter she finally made a three.
Chevy gets it back, puts it up and in, and a little bit of hope now for France. A little bit of full court pressure as well. Morrison might have been bumped there, but no foul called on Cardon. Not Fudd. And traveling. Turns it back over.
You know, that's a little... You see it here again. It's a travel in the international game. I think that kind of a move in the U.S., you know, it's allowed. It is. That's just kind of a little bit of the differences between the U.S. style game and the international game. It's definitely a travel here. When you slow it down, it's clearly a travel, probably in the U.S. also, but they let them do that there. So it's not uncommon to see the U.S. team get a few travel calls a game.
Fo2, beautiful drive, though. It doesn't make the shot, and the first team comes down with a terrific rebound. Final 12 seconds of the first quarter. France gets stopped. Okay, the USA stretch their advantage. Fudd misses with the jumper. Beckers gets it back. Oh boy, the second opportunity. And great play by Beckers. She stuck with it.
You know, look at this. It's a little bit after, but Cardon didn't even attempt to kind of get that rebound. You have to know that the game clock is winding down. There's only a few seconds left. Even if you don't get it, try and get a tip on it, because the Beckers can't get it and can't score.
21-12, the USA, 23-12, the USA on top of France here at the end of the first quarter. That should be 23-12. Thank you.
know, here we have some stats from the first quarter, 12-23, 23% from France. You know, it's not bad, but then you compare it to the 63% from the U.S., and that's the struggle. You know, you saw Iwodu starting it off good. They looked good, their first possession. Then they just started turning the ball over a little bit, and I think they were allowing the U.S. team to get too many easy baskets. I mean, we just saw 4 points in the highlights that were, they weren't even contested. There was no one around them.
Fotu had that shot rejected, but she came back, and I thought that was an important basket. The problem they have if you're France is you're already climbing uphill.
Yeah. You know, we talked earlier about this. They did it last night, so they know that they can do it. But doing it against a U.S. team that has so much firepower, and it's not just their ability to score. The U.S. can just buckle down and play defense. You know, they're tall, they're long. I mean, Horsten can switch with Jones easily on defense, so you almost have three interior, one tall wing player being able to switch. You have Beckers, who's taller than, you know, Pardon. So it's just tough. You do not want to get down, and I really think these first couple minutes are pretty important for France here.
Well, I'm really impressed by Boston. She starts here the second quarter. Beckers now over to Charisma Osborne, who's checked into the game. There's Jones, shot clock winding down. Jones puts it up, and then nobody boxes out Horsten. We just can't stop saying her name. She's utterly sensational. She just keeps finding ways to make contributions.
Absolutely. And, you know, right now she's my probably leading MVP go-getter.
Yeah, I would agree.
And I think just by watching the first, you know, 10 and a half minutes of this game, you know why. Defensively, she's getting steals. She's getting her hands on the ball. She can easily get the outlet and push it up court. She's very unselfish. And she can also knock down shots. And, I mean, that was an offensive rebound. In the air, tried to put it back, got the foul, and then goes and makes two free throws.
Well, she had 14 points in the first half yesterday against Hungary. This is a should be much taller order today against France, but already she's getting it done. Salon inside, nobody underneath for the rebound for France. Horsten for three, and France again don't rebound. Finally, Fotu catches it, pushes it forward on the break, takes it all the way, but she is blocked by Jones, and Jones leans over to help her up. Sportsmanship. You know that she's trying to get something easy, because nothing is easy right now when it comes to this end of the floor for France. What a play from Jones. Saw the pass coming. And then she is fouled by Sherry.
And that was just the defense out-hustling the offense, you know. Kendra Sherry thought that she had the defender on her back and then didn't move towards the entry pass from her guard, thinking, well, you know, the defense is there. And Jones just out-hustled her. And against the U.S., you have to go to every ball. You have to move. You have to, you know, expect that they're always going to be there.
Long shot, no good. Rebound, Boston. She gets blocked. We'll say keep it.
Nice idea by Horsten there, but I think her big wasn't really expecting a behind-the-back pass.
Turnover, and then another pass right into the hands of Horsten. Into Jones on the break. I've decided that she's got some magical power that makes her invisible. because it's just, you know, I mean, yeah, there's pressure to get rid of the ball because you're being hounded by somebody else, but how many times can you see the ball just turn right into a hand? And there she is, look at that. She jumps up and takes it away. Up ahead to Beckers, who lays it up and in. Now, the USA have got the wind in their sails right now and have stretched the lead to 29-12.
And it is Boyston.
Australia are thinking, wow. Played yesterday. That's
no,
what they did to us.
Definitely not. And, you know, maybe we're not on the court. You know, we're pretty close to the court, but maybe Boyston's march are I'm not really sure because, honestly, the steals that she has got, I think she anticipates.
Okay, keep working around in the post.
But
okay, next time down versus their zone, let's go
blue. Like, let's
see what we can get.
Really, it's incredible.
Flash hard.
It is incredible.
This might be a triple double.
She's getting to work on the boards. She's only got two rebounds. What's she doing out there? Nah, seriously. She's far and away right now. She's just outstanding. Beckers now with 6 points. Haley Jones, 6 points. And Pudd has 5 points. So a good balance for the USA.
Which, you know, going into this game, we know that is their strength. It is their bench. You know, they have four people scoring in double figures, but everyone else after that is kind of 9 points, 7 points. So they're really, everyone can score.
Madu has it from France over to Fotu Hacheri. Boy, she was well guarded already by Jones, and then Boston sealed the baseline. There was nowhere for her to go. She's got to get rid of it. Daisy Fudd to Jones with the passing, but it goes off the hands. Boston, right idea. Just didn't finish. Carlin Berube. What a great two-year run she's been in USA basketball. Puts it on the deck and throws it at the feet of Rupert, who has to bend over a long way to pick that one up, and she doesn't come close, to be honest.
And, you know, I think one concerning factor, not just one, there's many, but France, you already have 10 turnovers in this game. Against the U.S., that's not, like, even if you don't have the best shots, you can't turn the ball over. You know, that just leads to something worse than a bad shot.
Fotu with the rebound. Wadu for three. Good! They got to get something from somebody. She's hit a couple of threes.
You know, that was pretty well guarded by Fudd, but Wadu, she has a great and quick release.
From the baseline.
So smooth. There's no horsing around from Boyston tonight.
She got the pin between the teeth. Here's Wadu. That was long. Ball falls to Zumwalt. No, to Yale. And rebound.
Talking about France's turnovers, I'm saying you just can't turn the ball over. If you turn the ball over against the U.S., it's going to be 2 or 3 points easily. They've only averaged 14 and a half turnovers a game in this tournament. And 10 tonight, I understand they're playing a more athletic, a more physical team, but you've got to limit that the rest of this game if you want to give yourselves a chance.
Here's Wadu, gets it now to prepare. This is better. She's going to the basket. And was fouled by Bilibi. And that was the difference, really, as opposed to fading away.
Even then, you know, I think Jones had pretty good position, maybe just reached in kind of right at the end. You know, you see her kind of with her left arm there.
Rivera's going to try three. Good block spot. Knocked out by Jones. Ball goes off to France. It's interesting because you see so many USA players, top USA players, come over to Europe. These French players will undoubtedly face some of these USA players down the road, won't they?
Absolutely.
And whether it's in the French League, the EuroLeague women, Euro Cup women, another foul. And free throws coming for the USA, for the Americans.
And, you know, I have a feeling moving forward as well. Easy Fudd. Jordan Horston, you know, Beckers, Jones. Possibly we're going to be seeing these women also at the U19 World Cup in the future. And guess what? A lot of these French players are going to be there. So I imagine, you know, there's few people on either team are going to have a long battling career against each other moving forward.
Gets to the loose ball, the rebound. Just does it all. She'll get a double-double tonight, I would predict, as long as she gets the minutes. Zaya Cook for three. Hey, tomorrow to watch her. She's potentially a great one as well for USA. Sharif puts up a hook shot.
They just cannot find anything easy, you know. I like that Sherry's trying to be aggressive, but, you know, you have Gladue in the corner there, and they're not quite aware. You know, you see this U.S. team, they're very good at passing. They know where each other are. And I just think France needs to do a better job of being aggressive, penetrating, but finding their teammates.
Meanwhile, Fudd throws in another jumper, and the lead has ballooned to 22. Gladue pulls up at the line.
You hope that France, you kind of want to keep it probably between 12 and 15 points moving
good
forward.
Good steal, and Potu makes the layup. If they can get some stuff like that, I mean, no doubt it has to come up with some pressure. And the French coach tells these players, you got to move up. Let's get some pressure. Let's keep the pressure on. And that pressure there forced her to a rare mistake. She steps out of bounds. Eight steals for the USA in this game, and that is one of the two steals for France. 5'2".
And, you know, Cook just kind of became a little, I think she didn't really know what was going on, didn't know what to call, and very uncharacteristic of a U.S. team.
Feeling it, but still misses. Beckers now quickly to Belibi, and back to a 20-point lead.
I mean, that's your post player, Belibi, beating everyone else down the court. And I don't know if you noticed, that wasn't an easy pass that she caught and was able to put up.
Oh, guess what, Sean?
Sunday.
And?
The banks are open.
Yes, they are indeed. We are in Belarus for Sunday banking. And that takes it back to a 17-point deficit for France. A bit of somebody smiling on the French. On high on that one. There's Fudd over to Jones. It's good. Well, she's got a repertoire that's rather impressive as well, doesn't she? 9 points.
She really, you know, I love her game. And I really, I mentioned before, I think she's going to become, you know what she kind of reminds me of? Amaya Moore. You give her a couple more years, you let her develop more as a guard.
Yep. You're right. Here she is. Again, short on that one. And yet the USA forced him with the rebound. And now Fotu has it. And the France in transition, really, you feel like it's their best chance to score. And a foul called as the USA get back on defense.
And, you know, what France needs to figure out, they're in a zone, and I talked to you, you've listened to some of our previous games that we've done, it's very hard to box out in a zone. I'm not saying it's very hard, but you have to put a lot more effort into it, and all five people need to box out, and you're not really seeing that right now from the French team. They're almost boxing out and not going after rebounds aggressively. They're a little timid. It's as though they're a little afraid of this U.S. team.
Right, steps back, three, good! Good, speak. That was beautiful basketball.
And you know, before the game, I said, keep an eye out on Maureen Fautou. I didn't think she played great yesterday. And look at her stepping up right now when her team needs her most.
It has to be a good French word for that. I was trying to think of voila.
Voila.
Magnifique. Right. Turn out of Jones. Celeste Taylor. There's the baseline. Unless they pass it. Well, Becker's touch pass. Taylor. Oh. That was a thing of beauty there.
Yeah, it really was. A miscommunication there on the zone. There was no one talking, you know, about Taylor being underneath the basket. The zone needed to move over.
Shot clock winding down. This time she gets rejected by Fudd. Her defense is tough. Oh, and she just goes all the way. Well, I think we need to start talking more.
And 2 points.
I think we need to start talking more from the MVP with her on that move. That was impressive stuff.
And she's 15 years old. How scary is that?
Very. Wadu gets three back. Trade baskets in for France though.
No, and you know, France are lucky that they're hitting their threes because it's kind of what's keeping them in the game right now. Oh, 6 for 10 from three.
Who also in the game for France, by the way. Didn't mention that. Number 26, and a foul called. As fourth team foul out in France here with 22 seconds to go. In the first half. 46-28. It is imperative that they get a stop. Try to get another 2 points. And they get it. Becker's had an open look. Jones committed the foul. That's 14 fouls on the USA. And I suppose here that was a reprieve. Becker would have thought she'd make that. And also, I guess you want to hold her for one here, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you want to get a good look, you want to get a good shot, but you don't want to shoot too early and give a chance to the U.S. to score.
Don't want to turn it over. Final seconds, take it off. Fautou gets a little space. Well, that's how it finishes. And just a star-studded performance from the United States of America. As they run off the court for the halftime talk. Their coach, Carl Ambarubi, will say, you are 20 minutes away from a title. You got to keep playing hard. They lead it 46-28 over France. Halftime statistics?
I mean, you know, 60% from three. That's the reason why France is in this game. Six made threes. 61% from 2 point. You got to make things more difficult against the U.S. You know, and look at that. They have 12 assists out of that. Right? They just share the ball so well.
What about the steal or the nine steals?
Five
for the
from
USA. Horston, yeah. And 11 turnovers for France, which, you know, you turn it over against USA, they're going to turn it into points. And to illustrate, that's tell you how many they've got. They've got 9 points off of turnovers. So you don't have to play perfect basketball against USA, but you need to play exceptionally well.
You do, you know.
And we're not seeing the best from France. And their star coming into this game, who had the huge game yesterday, has had a dose of reality today, Drew Carey. And she, as you said, is facing the toughest bigs that she's faced in the tournament.
I think she's intimidated, and I hope that she comes out in the second half not so as intimidated, because France really need her moving forward.
So 46-28, USA on top of France at halftime. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Halfway home, the USA, they are leading it 46-28 at halftime over France. And, we know that France have the ability to come back. They knocked off the country that won the title, Australia. They beat them, the team that won it 2 years ago, Australia, they beat them yesterday after trailing by 15 points at halftime. That it's going to be a little bit tougher, in fact, a lot tougher against the United States. Although, France, if they can make some shots and get into their full court press, anything is possible. And we also saw their coach yesterday, Juliette, seems like he made the right moves yesterday. See if he's had any words of inspiration, wisdom, anger, whatever, that might trigger the turnaround today.
Yeah, you know, just looking at the stats from halftime, the U.S. have 9 steals. They're lucky that points off turnover, U.S. only have 9. Then again, they have 12 offensive rebounds, and they have 14 second chance points. There's just little things that I think France needs to do better. So they need to take care of the ball, and they need to box out. And you know what? If their shots don't fall, their shots don't fall. But don't give things to the U.S., if that makes sense, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
And I'm saying you need to box out. It's not as easy as it sounds.
No, for sure.
Obviously, not against a great U.S. team. And, you know, the thing is, going into this game, rebounds, the U.S. averaged 22.5 offensive, but France averages 19.5 offensive, and they only have 5 at halftime. So,
and that was a problem they had yesterday in the first half against Australia.
Yeah.
Not crashing the offensive board.
So, you know, I hope to see, maybe like yesterday, the coach had some wisdom and inspiration, and we'll see a different team come out. You know, and it's not over. This is 20 minutes. You know, that U.S. team ran out. They look good. They look happy. But maybe that's the time to attack them when they're a little comfortable. Moving forward, and you know, she was MVP of the Eurobasket 2016, U16s, has had a great tournament, has been MVP candidate going into this game. Obviously, she's going up against tougher competition, and I think no matter how this game ends for her, it's going to be a learning experience.
For 2 for 3, this is everything there.
Get up into their kind of press and then back into their zone. They do a better job against the U.S.
This time she holds her ground, but still Boston there, making dying difficult. Wadu ends up with a 3 and unsuccessfully launches it. Now Fudd gets it to Beckers. Play by Becker, but she's really racking up the assist today.
And you know, right now we see Rupert, and maybe at her age level and playing, you know, in NSAB, a good job by Wodu there, just kind of taking it strong. You know, she has moves, but she needs to develop counter moves, because right now the U.S., you know, they've studied her, they've had a game plan, they said this is what she likes to do, is to take away that. And they're doing that, and she doesn't have a counter move right now.
Well, Boston catches it down low, she's not going to miss that. Great play by the USA. Part of our first down, check for her as she's not going to the basket. And she's, again, just Boston is winning that. And Boston turns and scores. Well, she's been one of the more efficient players in this tournament coming into this game, seeing why.
Yeah, she has. And, you know, keep in mind, she's the captain of this team. So I think she does a lot more than statistically is shown. You know, she doesn't play the most amount of minutes. She's kind of in the average there, just a little over 17.
Jones catches it and is fouled by Rupert.
But, you know, with that being said, talking about Boston, she's almost averaging a double-double. She leads the team in rebounds at 7.6, with only playing just over 17 minutes and 11 points a game in this tournament. So she's clearly a big factor. She's kind of, you don't notice her. You don't notice what she does. Let's put it that way. Maybe she's not as flashy as a Horston, as a Beckers, as a Fudd. And, you know, she sort of flies under the radar, but she is just, she is battling her pair. She is frustrating her, especially on defense. I really like what she brings to this team.
There's Owodu, puts up a three. In fact, she was fifth in terms of efficiency. A lot of different things go into that coming into this game. In the tournament. Here she is again. Catches, scores, and the lead now 27 points. And you'd think that France needed a good start here at the second half to have a good chance, and it just hasn't happened. The USA just turning the screw.
Yeah, you know, I'm sure the French coach said, hey, you know what, the first 5 minutes of the third quarter are incredibly important, and guess what, the USA coach said, hey guys, the first 5 minutes of the third quarter are incredibly important, let's put them away, and that's what this US team is starting to do.
Prepare, gets it over to Wadu. Pulls up, and that's all to the left, just a little.
And you know, I think it would have been smarter to kind of challenge that 2-on-1, be a little bit more aggressive. But this is what I mean. I think they're a little intimidated by the U.S.'s size.
Beckers over to Jones, who goes up and is fouled in the lane. So two free throws coming for the Americans. Here she is again. So you look back at the USA in this tournament, and the first three, they won the title. They finished third back in 2006, and of course when they won this in 2010, they actually beat France near a field.
Those who are just tuning in today, I think she has an incredible amount of talent, and she's going to learn a lot from this. I think it's a good opportunity for her to see kind of where she needs to go and where she needs to get. If she wants to progress her career, which, you know, I'm sure she does, and there's a lot of talk from the FFBB, the French Basketball Federation, about this generation because, you know, as everyone knows, Paris 2024 is, you know, 6 years away, and this is a generation that's going to be representing them.
Jones at the line. Look back at the USA dominance in this event before 2016. And that 2010 team, the very first FIBA 117 World Championship for women in France, where they beat France in the final. Brianna Stewart was in that USA team.
Who knows women's basketball? She definitely She's finally coming over to Europe, so people for the next overseas season that, you know, starts in October after the World Championships in Spain. So there's a lot of excitement. A lot of European fans are going to get to see one of the best young women's basketball players. But she's still only about 24, 25, right?
Yeah. She's in her prime. So this is a loaded, it looked like a USA hand got on that ball. And Chevy got down the ground, but then she was surrounded by Jones, Beckers. Position error for the USA. Zion Cook enters the contest. And I believe he misses an easy one. Close one. And then foul called. So the USA on top, 29 points. They were up 18.
Yeah, you know, like coaches talk about the first 5 minutes, and it's not the same team that we saw come out after half against the Australian team yesterday, this France team right now. And
They were able to make some shots, and they were able to get into their press.
But even now, you know, you see them getting into their press, but it's as though, you know, yesterday they had five people completely engaged, being aggressive in their press, and right now they look a little timid. I think they're a little scared of the athleticism that this team has.
Has it taken away by Beckers, and now Fudd runs ahead on the break and scores. USA, you just have to sit back and applaud them. I have to admit, yesterday they dominated, but I didn't feel like, you know, Hungary gave them much of a test, but they just showed how good they are today against what was really, what we consider to be a really decent challenge against France. I mean, they had just come out and dominated.
Yeah, they had, and it's as though the U.S. knew that France was going to be more competitive, they're more athletic, they're more talented than the Hungary team, I believe, which is normal. I mean, this is the U16 Eurobasket 2016 champions. Hungary were silver in that event last year, so they are the better team right now. And it's as though the U.S. said, okay, well, you know what, we'll just pick up our game a little bit more as well.
She's just got that extra gear of quickness. She's going to believe it. She's going to believe it. Not able to finish. Chevy. Get it. Pardon. You know, it was interesting as well. I was in Argentina for the under 17 men recently, and it was France and the USA in that one as well. And the USA just really turned it on in that game. And that was a talented French team as well. And here, the USA driving, Zaka Cook, and draws the foul and goes to the line. Well, she was like,
she really is, and you know, she comes in off the bench for them, and she's not intimidated to be aggressive, to take her first open shot. You know, I like the way she plays. I like the way that what she gives them off the bench as well.
Zaya Cook, it's both of them. Well, again, really, for the second consecutive day, you have to say, early on, Horston, Jones, especially Horston, but also Jones, they were just like two best players early on for the USA. Really kind of set the tone. Beckers was good today, much better today than she was yesterday. Boston, obviously, is a huge performance against the pair. But again, you talk about the USA, you're talking about a lot of players. And that is their strength. They don't have to overwhelm one or two players or three players. I mean, they just come at you in waves.
They really do. I mean, you can sit here.
Horton misses from deep. 7 minutes have been played in the third quarter. Zaya Cook gets inside. And hey, she just almost makes it look easy. She just seems a step faster than everybody on the court.
exciting to watch. You know, she's gritty, she's fast.
Shetty is by Horston. Horston now goes the other way. Oh, beautiful pass by Horston and finished by Bellivi. Horston, 9 points, 9 rebounds, 5 assists, 5 steals. I don't think she'll stay in long enough. I think the coach will take her out. I hope she stays in, though. Here's, this time, Zaya Cook, open floor. She's exciting, hands it off, and Horston doesn't finish this time. A rare miss. And somehow France end up with a layup out of that. So, 4-point swing, but 66-33. It is all USA right now. Jumper at the line, Bellivi with the rebound, out to Horston, go! Just putting a little bit of one of the many exclamation marks that she's going to have on her performance in this tournament. 12 points now for her. One more rebound, she's got her double-double. And Bud is going to come out. Zaya Cook is going to come out. Charisma Osborne is going to check into the game, as well as Haley Van Lith. And like, again, yesterday, Van Lith played with a lot of purpose yesterday. Charisma as well. And here's Celeste Taylor getting the rebound. Horston looking a little tired. You know, she'll stay out there. She'll stay out alone to get a double-double.
One more rebound.
Yep. She needs. She's got the 12 points and 9 boards.
Maybe 4 more assists.
Bellivi gets inside. And she might have been passing that one to the referee.
Stick the ref. That's her teammate.
In France here, you just got to keep playing, don't you? You got to play hard. Make that score more respectable.
I mean, you don't get into a gold medal game and give up.
Exactly. Nice finish there by Chevy.
And you know, you're playing for the future. You're also playing to improve.
A lot of people are watching you right now.
Exactly. You know, people are watching you and how you finish, even if you are down, people notice those kind of things.
So 2 free throws coming for Bellivi. Seventeen 4 seconds to go in the third quarter. And the USA in total command as Bellivi goes. Dare I say it? Somebody just made a deposit on Sunday. It was Bellivi. She banked it in. And now,
I believe banks are open in the U.S. on Sunday.
Are they?
Yeah, I think it's just Europe that.
Well, we got online banks.
There you go.
At least international. Okay. Good hustle there by Celeste Taylor.
And you know what I love too? This U.S. team is not backing down either. You know, they could easily say, "Oh, okay. We're up 35, let's just cruise for the rest of the time," but that's not how they play. They've never played like that. And then again, you know, I've seen numerous coaches, numerous NCAA coaches in the stands. You know, I saw Texas jersey earlier today, Icon. So, you know, they're also playing for their future a little bit as well.
On top by 35 points. And right now it's almost the case of damage limitation for France. You are looking at a team that has the wind in its sails. They are 10 minutes away from lifting that title up 70-35. What about these numbers, Shona? I mean, what can we gather other than the fact that the USA made a lot more shots?
You know,
I mean, clearly they don't have to be a great three-point shooting team.
They don't, and that's, you know, there's a weakness. That would be it. I talked yesterday. I said, yeah, I think it's a good idea if France were to play zone and try and force the U.S. to take outside shots because they're not the greatest three-point shooting team in this tournament. But guess what? It doesn't matter because they still get the ball inside. They move it well. They're getting offensive rebounds against France's zone. So right now they're just battling them and playing better. And, you know, we just saw Boston score there who quietly, she's probably been one of the leaders and one of the best players on this team as well. You know, tonight she already has 10 points, 7 rebounds. She's close to a double-double, but you know, you look at all these players on this U.S. team, and Jordan Horston, who right now she's kind of my MVP go-getter. She has 12 points, 9 rebounds, 6 assists, 5 steals, and 3 blocks. Talk about a stat line. Then again, you know, let's talk about Becker, who you don't really notice her as much, but she is just so smart. She plays the second most minutes on this team. You know, her stat line reads, 6 points, 6 rebounds, 9 assists. So clearly she's not looking for herself.
Disappointment for French, no doubt about it. They didn't come today thinking they were going to, you know, lose. Certainly not be on the wrong end of a scoreline such as this, but such is the case. Nice play, USA executing, getting it to Boston. Takes a long one. Pass chased down by Jones. And the drive and the finish by Becker. She really has been good today. 6 points, 10 assists. She's been terrific.
I think it's 8 points now, yeah.
I think they've already had that one.
And you know, she's close to a triple-double. Like, this team just has so many weapons.
Repair just blocked once again by Boston. You know, as a low post player, Repair, where does she need to take, what steps does she need to take now? She's gonna make that next step.
Secondary moves. You know, I understand right there she kind of wanted to
shot a steal. Another steal. Oh, and Horston missed the layup. But as the USA do, they beat France down the court and they get the rebound. Unbelievable.
And you know, that was just, there were 3 French players down there for that rebound, and there was only 1 French player, and then the French players trailed in. So I don't know if they've kind of, you know, put their heads down and written this game off, but that's the difference right now. The U.S. are just outplaying them.
Someone misses from 3. Fudd with the rebound. Boston calls the play. And Boston is fouled. So she will go back to the free throw line. She's got 14 points today, 8 rebounds, Boston. And Jones comes out for the USA. Brunell comes into the game for her first minutes. Both teams go to the bench for a timeout with 7.5 minutes, 7:37 remaining.
Let's just get a timeout here and see what kind of
true. I think a lot of their points that is an expectation from the corner there, okay?
And very one-on-one, kind of off their own creation, some crazy shots. So that's why you see that big assist difference.
Probably make a case for about several USA players being on the all-tournament team. Strong case, but there's only so many spots. As is always the case, Boston now goes to 15 points. Probably have a wrong there if they run to me. Thanks both. We got 16 points and 8 rebounds in this game alone. So 2 blocks.
Samantha Grinnell has just checked in for this USA team, and if there's one person who knew what it felt like for them to lose in the semifinals in 2016 to Australia, it's her. She's the only returning player who was on that team, so she has experience for these guys, and like I said yesterday, I'm pretty sure she was in the locker room before the game kind of hyping her teammate up and saying, hey, listen, we got to come out from the get-go. We got 40 minutes.
Goodness me, Belibe, how in the world did she score there? Fouled
and
on the play
by Brunel,
by
you know?
Award.
Wow.
Award. Chevy's going to come out. Also coming in is Wauku, 26. Yale is coming out.
Can hear the U.S. fans in the background chanting MVP as
Horsten goes
came
out of the gown.
Yeah.
Yep. Well, he makes the free throw. Nice release. 8-5. Final yesterday, France are guaranteed the top 2 finish, and the team they beat, Australia, you know, came into today not, you know, knowing that they would finish at least 4th or 3rd. They end up winning their game against Hungary, so they finished 3rd. They're going to be leaving all smiles today. Meanwhile, the USA makes some substitutions. France are going to leave the undefeated team.
Yeah, there you go. I mean, you know, it's always tough losing in any game. But so they might be unhappy today and tonight, but tomorrow with when they get off the plane and they have that silver medal and their parents and family are at the airport.
Yeah.
And as time goes on, they're going to be very, very proud about this performance. And they're, you know, more than anything, they're probably going to remember that Australia game.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's exciting.
Tanner Brink is into the game for the USA. Number 13. Face-on-face contact there, jaw-on-jaw with Celeste Taylor. Look at this. This is called tussling. Oh, oh no, it wasn't face-on-face. It was right elbow on the face.
Yeah, you know, it was inadvertent. It wasn't on purpose. I mean, both of them were hustling after the ball.
Another opportunity for USA, who might not get to 100 points in this game.
No, you know, they've averaged just under 90 points for this tournament, so who knows? 446 left. I mean, if they have easy baskets like that, and you know what? That's actually the same advanced pass that they ran a couple minutes into the game. The same inbounds and the same easy layup.
It's probably an element of really having to bear down and concentrate for France at this stage. 4.5 minutes to go and you're down 4 or 5 points.
I don't know, you tell me.
We talked about this yesterday. You were on some long ends of results against the USA over the years with Canada. And it's not easy, especially when you start getting run out of the gym.
It definitely is not easy, but you know, you never gave up though, because you knew you were just trying to get better. So you always wanted to go every possession, you know, you, and especially other people right now, you know, people have checked into the game, who've been giving it, you know, Yale is in now for France, and you're getting opportunity and you want to show your coach, hey, you know what, I can play. So maybe not in this tournament because we're down to the end, but in future tournaments, like, trust in me, look what I did, even in those few minutes when we're already down 46.
Brink is on the score sheet, and it's both, in fact. The Americans in the stands traveled a long way to watch their strong performance from their compatriots and for many of their family members, the most of them probably. Pulls it off. Jenna can get some back over for two. Basketball. Brunel misses.
Kind of got it the wrong time. So she's heading stateside. I'm not quite sure where she's headed yet.
Okay.
So who knows? She might, you know, be going up against some of these girls.
We saw Deandra Chachouan. Is that right? France International now. She played in Maryland.
She did. Yeah, she was in Maryland for 2 years, I believe. There's a couple French players who left in set. Hot just like how I played at Utah, and it was kind of a
Canadian.
Yeah, there you go. So, and obviously, it's easy to talk to other Canadians and follow in the footsteps of other Canadians, and that's what I did, and people did that after me, and you know what to expect then.
What were they serving there to make Canadians at the train table? Okay, so 2:48 to go, and America marching towards their fourth title. 17 women's basketball World Cups. Van Lith, one of the two. Yeah, it was on Brink. So I guess I'll go back and reassess, and you know, if coach has any advantage here for France, is that he'll have them back at INSEP, and you know, they'll go back and look at the tape, a lot of them, and they'll, if it doesn't kill you, it makes you stronger.
Yeah, and absolutely.
It certainly hasn't killed them, although it's been a whipping today, and they now know. If they didn't know already, they know that there's a very good team across the Atlantic that is they're going to have to beat to become the number one team in the land, or in the world. Van Lith, the lefty, strikes and takes it to 90 points for the USA.
I think they're starting to feel it. They maybe felt it a little earlier, but I just love how they support each other and they're excited for their teammates, even those who don't get a ton of playing time.
Shot clock, rather. You know, going back to that point I was just making, if you go back to 2010, when USA beat France 92-62 in the final. Olivier Apoupa was in that France team. And she has since gone on to, you'd have to say, great things in her career.
She has, you know, she's played at the Olympics since then. She has played EuroLeague in France with Villeneuve-Dasque, the team there. She also played in the French League, and this year she just had a great season. One of the top rebounders in EuroLeague is steals in Galatasaray in Turkey. So, to say the least, that some stars have come out of this tournament is an understatement. So, to be here, to be in the finals, you have to know that's pretty good for your resume and it's pretty good for your future.
Yeah, Li Ming, that played for China back in 2010, she's a big player for them now. Other players. We talked about Neera Fields was the Canadian who led all scores at that tournament. But right now, we're looking at some Americans who quite simply are going to have great careers, and it'll be fun watching them develop. Ball gets out of bounds. France will keep it 38.31 seconds.
Yeah, there'll be a lot of eye on these young Americans in the next year or two when they start to make their college decision. A lot of them are going to be going into their junior year, and you know, that's when you start to go on your official visits to schools and whatnot. And that's why we see so many NCAA coaches here at this tournament who also came all the way to Belarus to watch these women play. And don't get me wrong, those NCAA coaches, they're not here just for the USA team. They're also here, they're scouting all these other teams that are here as well.
Tisha Romero played for Spain back in 2012. She's now one of their senior team players, big-time player. USA, it's all about them right now. Look at them on the bench. They are going to have a result on their CV that they will never lose. They will be World Cup winners. FIBA Under 17 Women's Basketball World Cup has been won by the USA 92-40. Absolutely emphatic. And I'll tell you what, deserving winners, to put it mildly. They have been utterly brilliant. And they saved their best for last. I mean, they were an awesome day.
They really did.
No stopping them.
Going into this game, I thought if France could come out and play the way that they did yesterday in that second half against Australia, that they could definitely give the U.S. a run for their money, even after watching the U.S. play.
92-40, the USA win it over France. They are the World Cup winners. We saw some emotion there from France, Shona, and you know, it is. They're tired. They probably had their high hopes, and they've had their hopes dashed of a title. But at the end of the day, USA deserving winners. And I have to say, they've been classy about this performance. They've been good. They've been professional. They've come out, and they deserve to celebrate right now.
Absolutely. And, you know, look at the stats here. 60 points. They didn't even need the threes. And, you know, France, they only made one three in the second half, and I think that's what kind of kept them in the game a little bit. Clearly out-rebounded. 56-30. U.S. had 19 offensive rebounds. France was averaging 19. They need to do a better job. 16 turnovers. They did a pretty good job of forcing the U.S. into 12 turnovers. But, I mean, in every category, the U.S. just sort of dominated them. Wadu, 16 points. You know, the shooter for France. Clearly, anywhere that's just outside the three-point arc, she thinks she can make. And I thought she did a great job tonight. And she fought. She tried really hard. Horsten with six steals. You know, I think she's a pretty big candidate for that MVP. And then Jones, I mean, she was also, she would be an MVP candidate, as well as Boston and Becker. So
there's any number of players, we talked about it, any number of players for USA that can find themselves on the alternative team today. It'll be interesting to see who gets it. And I don't know, for me, Horsten has to be the MVP. I mean, I just thought the last 2 days, she was just... wow, she was just at a different level.
Yeah. I agree with you. Don't forget about Fudd, AZ Fudd, 15-year-old, youngest in this tournament. And she already has a little record to her name. She was the youngest player at a FIBA event last year as a 14-year-old at the U16 2006 America's Championship. So she has a very bright future ahead of her. Do you know what I love? I mean, you look at the stat sheet of the U.S., 16 points by Boston, so, you know, she leads all scores. And then a different player, Beckers, has 10 assists. She's the leader in that. And then we go look at Horsten with the six steals. I mean, every category that you look at, someone else on their roster owns that category, and that's just how powerful they are. It's great to see.
Well, we saw some absolute crushing looks from France as they walked off the court. It's almost gotten me choked up looking at some of the girls crying. And they're just like devastated because they know this is a once-in-a-lifetime deal. And they've come up far short. But, you know, again, you have to really say if it doesn't kill you, it makes you stronger. And hopefully they'll build on this and they'll go on to bigger and better things. And I'm pretty confident that's what's going to happen. Already worked this hard to get this far. And just enormous pride for the USA players. It's great to see their parents and family members that have come this far to watch and support their kids.
Yeah, you know, I think it's awesome. And you mentioned earlier some of those French players, the tears in their eyes, and you know what? They have really bright futures, and this is what hurts the most. But I think they're going to have other opportunities, many of them, and they're going to learn from this moving forward. And, you know, one of my favorite players is Manu Ginobili. And I remember he gave an interview after the Rio Olympics when he was retiring from his national team, and he just said, I had some absolutely amazing and happy moments, but I also had some hard and heartbreaking ones at the same time. And that's just how you feel when you play for your national team. It is. There's no two ways about it.
Yeah, it's, well, you know better than me. because you've done it.
Yeah. So. And I've had, you know, those moments that are as high, and I've had moments that are as low. And you learn from them, and you realize that's just, that's part of life, that's part of basketball, and that's part of representing your country and having so much passion, having your country's name across your chest.
So there is the trophy. It will be going to the U.S. of A., the United States of America. And again, just a great event. Congratulations to Belarus as a country for putting this on. You know, their women's senior team really, for a decade, really, made a lot of headlines in international basketball, national team basketball. Third place in Kieti at the Eurobasket Women 2007. They rose from Division B like rapidly, and then they went to two Olympic Games, so it's great. And also they played at two FIBA basketball, Women's Basketball World Cups. So it's great to see this country host a premier event like Under 17 Women's Basketball World Cup, the Belarus Women in Transition. But we are now going to be seeing the honors, the All-Star Five, and also the teams will be coming out to get their honors. We'll see All-Star Five, we'll see the MVP.
The awards will be presented Mr. Turgay Demirel, FIBA Executive Committee Member, and Mrs. Anastasia Marinina, Belarusian Basketball Federation General Secretary.
Comes out. And Natasia Marinina. So Turgay Demirel, the FIBA Executive Committee Member,
the best place
and the Belarusian
of the
Basketball
FIBA on the
17th
Women's
Secretary
Basketball
Natasia
World
Marinina.
Cup 2018, our All-Star Five.
They
please
will be,
welcome
Alias
Boston from USA, number 14.
Boston, not surprisingly, really. Man, she was good today.
Yeah.
She just basically neutralized the threat of repair inside, and she's made
All-Star
Five.
Shayla Hill, Australia,
Shayla
number
Hill
four.
Makes it. She was she rescued her team today in the fourth quarter. 14, I think it was 14 or 16 points.
It was. She waited until the last 10 minutes, but she did it, and she carried her team to the bronze medal.
She did it on purpose because of the, she said, just to make it a little bit more dramatic.
Jordan Houston from USA, number eight.
Jordan Houston, absolutely no surprise. She's made this All-Star Five.
No, without a doubt. I mean, her performance, her, you know what it is about her? She's just such an all-rounded player.
All-Star Five, please welcome Haley Jones from USA, number 10.
And Jones, who's fantastic at the start of each of the last couple of teams as well. And really throughout, he makes it.
And please welcome Iliana Rupert from France, number 12.
Has made it as well. And I have to say, it's quite moving. You can't see it in your screen, but to see her French teammates really cheering for her to come out and receive this honor, that is fantastic. It's kind of brightened the mood over there in the French camp.
It has, and you know, she had a disappointing outing today, but she had a learning experience, that's for sure. And keep in mind, you know, we talked, she's battling an ankle injury this entire tournament, and still made the All-Star
USA.
Yeah.
Shayla Hill, Australia. Jordan Houston, hey, USA.
That is your All-Star Five.
Haley Jones, USA.
A lot of pride.
And Juliana Rupert,
and I have
France.
To say, you could have easily had two or three more Americans in that All-Star Five. But you know what? I say it at every tournament. I mean, they just, you know, it is such a tough selection process. I mean, how do you come up with it?
For the Tissot Most Valuable Player, the Tissot MVP,
is going to be presented.
Presented by Mr. Turgay Demirel, FIBA Executive Committee Member. The Tissot Most Valuable Player of the FIBA Under 17 Women's Basketball World Cup 2018 is Jordan Houston.
And Jordan Houston gets the MVP. That's for me a no-brainer. I mean, she basically took over the game the last couple of days early. She just basically said, you know what? Let's just lay the foundation. for the wins.
I mean, those NCAA coaches that are in the stands right now, they're salivating.
Yes.
She is a player who is going to be recruited by the best schools in the U.S., there's no doubt. And I'm sure it's already been going on for a few years. And really, her game is unbelievable. She is able to do everything. But you know what I love? It was her defense. She is everywhere. I can't, you know, I mean, today it was steal after steal after steal. And the best part is, after she gets the steal, she has the ball handling skills to push the ball, bring it up the court. And then she also has the whereabouts and the ability to make the extra pass or finish herself. And she is just,
this concludes
as a 17-year-old, she is already so well-rounded. I think this is someone we're going to see in a USA jersey for a long time to come.
Bronzovых призеров чемпионата мира. Third place team in the FIBA Under 17 Women's Basketball World Cup 2018 is the team of Australia.
So now comes the presentation of the medals, and this will be unforgettable experience for all these ladies as they make their way to the podium. Stepping up to the podium. Stepped up to the podium how many times?
A couple times with Canada and the Americas.
Yeah? What's going through your mind when that happens? You just don't want to take a wrong step?
Yeah, you don't want to trip.
Bronze medalist, Team Australia!
Because, you know, they actually fit all three teams onto the podium, so you're kind of...
The bronze medals are presented by Anand Young, FIBA Vice President, and Igor Yurkevich, Deputy Chairman of Minsk City Executive Committee.
So... Australia, very deserving. Again, they came back today. It was a heartbreak for Hungary. They checked into the Heartbreak Hotel.
Team captain Isabel Palmer, number seven,
is the vice president. As well as Mr. Igor Yurkevich, the deputy chairman of the Minsk City Committee.
Alexander Poland. Number 50.
Will advance to that next stage of the national team competition for the U.S. Or sorry, excuse me, the national team, the senior team.
You know, I think in this tournament, especially the final four, you know, the last four teams, there's a few players in every one of these teams that are going to be moving on, and I think they're going to be staples in their national program for a long time to come. This is a very talented bunch of young girls.
So you're talking about also, it might come too early. It probably does come too early, but you never know. The 2020 Olympics is around the corner. The USA probably say probably not, because they've got so much talent.
Australia has a lot of talent.
They do. It might be an outside shot for one or two of them.
France has a lot of talent.
Yeah, but you're talking about 2024 for France, and that's a more realistic.
This tournament right here, I think there's a lot of players that we saw in, you know, these three medal teams especially. I think we will see them, quite a few of these players in 2024 in Paris at the Olympics.
So now the silver medals are coming out. They'll be presented by Lena Wallen-Kansi, the FIBA Executive Committee member from Sweden. Demirel is from Turkey. He used to be the Turkish Basketball Federation president. So Lena Wallen-Kansi comes out. And also Mr. Maxim Ryzhnikov, the Belarus Basketball Federation president. They'll be presenting silver medals.
Presented by Mrs. Lena Wallen-Kansi, FIBA Executive Committee member, and Maxim Ryzhnikov, chairman of Belarusian Basketball Federation.
Everybody talks about the medals, but what about the flowers?
Love your hands.
You know, a lot of those flowers, like, people put those flowers on.
Number
congratulations to him, Belarus, for putting on a good show. He's got the full range of emotions and happiness. He was the first one to jump up in the bottom of the third quarter. McCarr was held back and told he was in the alternative. So Hughes was talking, we talked about that with Neil in the first game. And you can see how Hughes, the captain, isn't he?
And the same with Neil, like you said, another point guard, and it's just that's a point guard character. It really is. That's a good point guard character to have.
So, and again, as every minute now. That France push themselves away from the final, they will begin to remember the good times from this tournament. It's like golf in a way. You always forget the bad shots from the good shots. And they're going to remember coming from 15 points back to beat Australia. I think that's Pro 2 there.
Победители чемпионата мира. And now, our FIBA Under-17 Basketball World Cup 2018 champions.
USA.
Ladies and gentlemen,
we'll now get
your biggest applause for the winner of the FIBA Under-17 Women's Basketball
Moratori, the FIBA
World
president.
Cup 2018. Team of the United States of America.
Minister of Sport and Tourism of the Republic of Belarus. He will be handing out medals for the USA.
Team USA.
And there they are. Step up to the podium. And
by Mr. Carazzo Muratore, FIBA President. And Alexander Baraulia, Deputy Minister of Sports and Tourism of the Republic of Belarus.
It's a great moment for everybody. See, Moratori coming out. So out of all of these players that we see getting, Boston has gotten a lot. They've all got a lot, but Boston's just quite intimidating today. There must be a lot of people looking at her thinking, she can come and play for my team.
Absolutely. I mean, so let's not forget about
Asia.
15-year-old. Zaya Cook. Honestly, every person on this team, they're just going down. I think it's a very bright future. I think they're going to be highly recruited.
They will get bigger. They will get stronger. They will
smarter,
and
scary.
It is. So there they are, and we're also going to hear the national anthem of the United States played as they raise the flag, all the flags rather, to the rafters. Thank you. So now comes the trophy presentation. It just keeps getting better and better for these American players.
Celebration is never ending.
No, it's not. Captain Boston will receive it from Senor Muratori from Argentina. He will then walk over and yes, I don't think she's going to throw it over there, although she is a good passer. Here it is. Yep. So it is one final celebration. Well, I'm guessing they'll have quite a celebration today. The USA, they have won the title. Any closing remarks, Shona?
I think it was a great tournament. Thank you for tuning in. Hey, these women are going to be around for a while, so keep an eye out on them. And wow, what a US team it was. They're scary.
Can't say I'm surprised, although you do have to remember, 2 years ago, it wasn't a done deal. They finished third, and it was Australia that finished top of the podium. Maybe that added that little bit more hunger to USA basketball this time around. They came out all guns blazing, and again, they won it at a canter, going unbeaten and winning the title. So, as they posted their pictures on their medals and the trophy, but from Belarus, Shona, thanks very much. I'm Jeff Taylor. Thanks for watching. Head on a swivel, you know, serving me's a no-no. Clean as a whistle as I pull out in my Rolls Royce. Yellow bone passenger, they see it, they say, oh, boy. Tell Kelly back it up. Завершён чемпионат мира по баскетболу среди девушек до 17 лет. Столица Республики Беларусь в городе Минске. Еще раз поздравляем победителей сборную США, а также серебряных призеров команду Франции и The FIBA Under 17 Women's Basketball World Cup 2018 is now officially closed. Thank you to all the teams who have taken part in this event.
Out of options, cause I've been going off and they don't know when to stop. And when you get the top, and Bye.